Welcome to Cinemeric Live, application technology made easy. The aim of this series of short videos is to present specific topics on the practical use of Cinemeric. Today we want to address an exciting cutting-edge topic: flexible CNC programming. This allows us to make optimum use of the extremely large scope of languages available with Cinemeric and enables us to adapt our CNC programs flexibly to the production order in hand. Now we can implement jobs that we couldn't even imagine with classic DIN ISO programming. However, our topic, flexible CNC programming, is a very extensive one and would go beyond the scope of just one Cinemeric Live video. That's why we've decided to create a video series to teach the basics of flexible CNC programming step by step. The individual parts of these videos build on each other and should therefore be watched in chronological order. Topics covered include mathematical operators, control structures, and subprograms. So, what can we expect today? First, I'll show you some typical flexible CNC programming applications. Then, I'll introduce the basic Cinemeric onboard tools for flexible CNC programming. So, let's start with the applications of flexible CNC programming. We'll begin with versatile part masters. What do we mean by this? Quite simply, workpieces of the same type that are produced in different sizes or different variants. Take this tool adapter, for instance, which comes in different sizes. For example, HSK63, a hollow taper shank, or as seen here, HSK100. The CNC programs are identical, but are adapted to the respective version using parameters. You need flexible CNC programming to be able to do this. Another topic is custom user cycles, that is, recurring machining sequences that cannot be implemented with either the Cinemeric cycles or those of the machine manufacturers. Let's look at this handle of a hand wheel. Its geometry is based on sine curves. To permit this machining path, a separate cycle was created. Now, to calculate the desired sine curve in the cycle, only a few parameters need to be transferred. Another case for flexible CNC programming are production-related issues. These are often minor details that result in more performance as well as more transparency. Think of special operator messages on the CNC display, or even bigger, the generation of your own log files. To define when each workpiece is to be produced, for example. And which onboard tools are available to generate CNC programs that are as flexible as possible. First of all, we need user variables. Cinemeric offers a wide range of different types of variables in addition to the familiar R parameters. These can be accessed via CNC programs. The user-definable local user data are important for calculating the machining parameters. Mathematical operations are required to adapt the values for machining to the manufacturing job in hand. Cinemeric also offers a large number of CNC language commands for this purpose. These can be applied and combined in CNC programs as desired. Depending on the result of the mathematical calculation, we have to make a few choices for our machining strategy. Complex machining sequences described in flowcharts can be directly converted into CNC language commands for program control. This is an important tool, especially in custom user cycles. Now we've already arrived at another point. How and where do I package my flexible CNC program sequences? Do I write these in the main program or the subprogram? Or do I write a separate user cycle altogether? Cinemeric offers a highly flexible subprogram technique for this purpose. In this first video, we've demonstrated the benefits of flexible CNC programming and got a first overview of the CNC onboard tools for versatile programming. To stay up to date with using Cinemeric and to find out when there's a new Cinemeric Live video, it's best to subscribe to the CNC4U newsletter. Enter CNC4U in your internet search engine, sign up, and you're all set. So that was the introduction to our video series on the topic of flexible CNC programming. That's it for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time.